guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Sierra Spongy, and today I'm gonna go ahead and do an album review. This is my first time doing an album review, but I'm super excited to tell you guys who I think has the best album against the Migos. So as you guys already know, it's three Migos. It's Quavo, Offset, and Takeoff. So I'm gonna be going through all three of their albums and telling you who I think is the best album between all three. Also, I'm gonna be telling you guys my favorite songs that's on there. So let's go ahead and get started and get things pumping. Damn. Okay, you guys, let's go ahead and get things started. Let's talk about Quavo's album. Quavo's album was called Quavo Honcho, and it has 19 songs on it. Overall about his album, I really liked his album. I felt like every song was like a hit. It wasn't like hit or miss. Every song, all 19 songs, I can say that I could go into my car, use it as my playlist, or do my makeup with it and keep playing it back to back. So overall, I think his album was amazing. I have four favorite songs. It's the one that he talked about, Nicki Minaj, which is Honcho Dreams. The next one is Rerun with Travis Scott, which I really like that song. I always have it on replay. The next song is Shine. Get your shine, like a VVS, she got all that type of shit, get that check, I like that song, and I like How About That. How about the whole gang get geek, yeah, how about that? How about the whole gang get freaks, yeah, how about that? How about that? I can go on and sing these songs, but I thought all four are my favorite, especially Nicki Minaj, because when that first came out, everybody was wondering, like, did him and Nicki Minaj actually have something going on? Which, personally, I think they did have something going on. And then he addressed Safari in it, and everybody was going crazy, like, what's going on with Quavo and Nicki Minaj? Is it true he just dropped this song? What is it? What's going on? Everybody wanted to know what's going on. And of course, you know, things died down and simmered down because he's with Sweetie, whatever her name is. Ain't nobody paying attention to her, okay? I really like her because she's with my man, but that's besides that. We're gonna stay on topic, but I liked all four of those songs out of the 19 songs. So what we're gonna do is, during this album review, we're gonna play at least one song out of all three of their albums. So today I'm gonna go ahead and play the video for How About That, and we're gonna get things started and see what's going on. This is my favorite song from Quavo's album. How about it? Of course, they're playing basketball. It's like a team thing. Here comes Quavo, sexy ass with a ball. Oh! We get it going, let's go. Don't need no keys to go. No keys, fucking with me, get go. Nobody seen LeBron, they seen him living like fast, you go fast. Keeping it going, let's go. Keeping it going, let's go. You know, keeping it going, let's go. How about the whole gang get geeks, yeah. How about that? How about the whole gang get freaks, yeah. How about that? How about we run the whole scene, yeah. How about that? Hey, whole scene, yeah. How about that? Hey. Move the same, move the block. I'm with the team, we all stars. Hey, it's all I got. I can't stop. Came from kicking the doors, how about being shooting at us? She gave me mouth. Yeah. these niggas in basketball. Slam dunks. Quavo. So sexy.
What did you tell the team at halftime?
I said, how about the game get geeked?
How about that?
How about we run the whole scene?
How about that?
You got that?
How about that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next question. Champagne, rosé.
Rosé.
We keep it going, let's go, go. Don't need no keys to go, no keys. Fucking with me to go, me. Nobody seen LeBron, seen no keys.
Let me let back to go. Hey. Keep going, you go. Keep going. Hey. 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 The whole gang get geeked, yeah. How about that? How about the whole gang get freaked, yeah. How about that? How about we run the whole scene, yeah, yeah. Hey, whole scene, yeah, yeah. How about that?
How about
the whole gang get geeked, yeah, yeah. How about that? How about the whole gang get freaked, yeah, yeah. How about that? How about we run the whole scene, yeah, yeah. How about that? Whole scene, yeah, yeah. How about that? Like I said, that was my favorite song. How about that? Quavo did an amazing job with his album. Kudos to you. I tell you, all 19 songs, I could listen to it and have to replay it. One of my second favorite songs is Rerun by him and Travis Scott. Ladies, listen to that. It's definitely a must, definitely a replay. But next, we're going to go ahead and get started with Takeoff's album. Takeoff's album was named Last Rocket, and he had a total of 12 songs on his album. I have 5 out of 12 songs that were my favorite, and they were Vacation, Infatuation, I Remember, Casper, and Last Memory. All 5 songs, I can definitely have those on my playlist to replay while I'm doing my makeup, or if I'm in the car driving. So we're gonna go ahead and get things started and see which one was actually my favorite song off of Takeoff's album. I do wanna say before I go into the video that I was actually surprised with Takeoff's album, because he's like, out of all 3 of them, he seems like the more reserved one, like not in the spotlight or in the shine. As he would say, is, you think I was left off Bad and Bougie? Yes, you were left off Bad and Bougie, because we did not hear you in Bad and Bougie. So, but we're gonna go ahead and get things started and play my favorite video, favorite song from Takeoff's album, Last Rocket. So let's get started. Last Rocket, of course, The Quest for Selena. Okay, wherever Selena is. And of course, you guys see, it's Casper. Okay. This is actually my first time watching the video to this, so you guys will be getting my natural reaction.
Stay in your place. Set up and stay out of the way. M-E. No flare with the ice on fleek.
No flag.
Walking out with the bag in my seat.
Walking out.
No clock, all fast when I speak.
No clock.
Right break with the red and black seats.
Break.
Pulling up like a pocket with me.
Pulling up.
She gon' fame when she see the double R. When she find out, cast her with me.
Bad
bitch.
Small waist, pretty face.
Pretty. Having my way. She let me nut on the face.
Stay in your place.
Stay in your
place. Shut up and
stay out the way.
Shut up. Just mind what I'm gonna do today. I'ma go ride the red ghost. I'ma go ride the red. I just like the melody of this song. Okay. So let's get back into things. With Takeoff's album, like I stated, I had 5 songs that I liked off of it. This is one of my favorite songs. Definitely could have his album on repeat, Last Rocket. And I was definitely surprised of Takeoff's album, literally, because like I said, he's more a reserved type. He's like behind the scenes. He's not like Quavo with all the ad-libs or Offset who wants to be seen. Even when I was at their concert in Atlanta in September, he wasn't really like interacting with the crowd. He just likes to, you know, rap his part and be done. But overall, it really showed me his side as to being a Migo. Like, I could take him out of Migo game and know that he's gonna sell records, if you guys get what I'm saying, by himself. He's not relying on Offset or Quavo to make money. So that's a good thing, because this album definitely shows him like, wow, I could be a solo artist, and here I am, and here's my music. So definitely, hands down to Takeoff. You're not left off Bad and Bougie now that I heard this, and you did a great job on your album. So let's go ahead and get things started next with the last Migo, and that is Offset. So let's get started. Okay, you guys, so let's go ahead and talk about Offset's album. Offset's album is named Father of Four, and of course in his album he's talking about all his life experience, what he went through as a child, his kids, all his trials and tribulations. Now, regarding Offset album, I have a few songs that I like. I like Lick, Made Man, Don't Lose Me, and Quarter Mill with Gucci. I like all those songs. I wouldn't say that his album is something that I would replay. I just listened to it maybe once or twice and I was like, okay, it's okay. It's not, ooh, like I'm jumping for joy, but it's okay. I don't know if it's because, you know, he's talking about his life things, but I don't see that's like something that's like, oh, it's a hit. Like, I think it was kind of like a hit or miss with his album. Some songs are a hit, some songs are a miss. But overall, I think his album was okay. It wasn't great. You know, he's talking about his kids. He's talking about Cardi B. He's talking about his life experience, his mom, his dad, what he went through. He's basically talking about, I guess you could say, substance. Some things that rappers don't really talk about. There's nothing wrong with talking about, you know, what you've been through or anything like that. But when you're talking about it, make sure the song is a hit, okay? You know, and this album kept getting put back weeks and weeks at a time, months at a time, and finally here it is. It was supposed to drop in December, and now he just recently dropped it in February, which was last week or 2 weeks ago. So we're gonna go ahead and get things started, and I'm gonna tell you which song is my favorite song. This is actually my first time seeing this video, so.
Citizens, on the pilot this week, about the Bandit Brothers strike,
beer
to the
office. It's the old school.
Over 20 million missing, the National Treasury has issued
video.
A warning to all financial institutions. Who knows when they will strike again?
I don't think you guys noticed by now, I'm a trap music kind of gal, okay? Trap music girl.
I had to grab a chop for the stat. Mama ain't a name for my daddy. Fuck the king with the dream.
about the same, need glasses. Get the flow and out the lane like a ladder. Had to switch my lane, my passes. Rolls Royce, since it goes like cash. Came through dripping in a Pico. I was sitting in the three, next to Rico. But that ain't on the trying to keep low. Put the AP on my mama, she on Fleco. Double C's on my feet, bad Latino. I got 13 million in Marino. Don't work in a gym, work a kilo. Knock, knock, who is that? Check the people. Get the kicking like a kettle. Diamond dancing like Fabo. Trip a nigga ass when I say so. With a Glock, not a Draco. Glock. Connect the dots like a Lego. Chicken in the wheel, Mako. We did the independent takeover. I make a bitch, get the Mako. Kick back like a Maybach, bitch. Better yet, with the beam back then. Stay clean and the money coming in. 1988, my lens. But the bitch, that she ate her friend.
Gucci! Gucci!
This bitch. 100 racks, I can blow it in the wind. I made a whole meal off the chip. Bought a rich man, quarter million rich man. Sipping out the cell, hurt the kisses. Trapping Bobby, RIP the witness.
Let
me get a truck on
get. Get me.
Automama gets 150.
50.
Small man make one call.
One call.
Hit him with the saw. Pull up for Roderick Cross. Pull up for my wrist on frost. I went roll gold with the pistol. I had to grab the chopper for the stack. Mama is a name for my dad. Mama with the game with the dream work glasses. Keep the rings like the same knee glasses. Flowing out the lane like a ladder. Still so whiz off seeing and we got so much bread.
Gucci. Okay, so that concludes the video. Of course, you guys already know my favorite song from Offset's album was Quarter Mill with Gucci Mane. Now let's go ahead and get into his album. Like I said before, I don't see that his album is something that I would replay. Definitely something I would probably not listen to, no offense. That's just my preference. I think that out of all the Migos, he was dead last. And who I think who had the best album between all three of them. He was the third one. And to be honest with you, it's really, 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 really a tie between Quavo, Honcho, and Takeoff's last Rocket album. Now, with Quavo, I had 4 songs that I liked out of 19 songs. And with Takeoff, I had 5 songs out of the 12 songs that he had on there. So it's just really, 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 really hard. I am loyal, so I'm gonna stay down and I'm just gonna be honest of whose songs that I can really listen to. Doing my makeup, because that's how I get my creative juices flowing. So I would guess I would say, dang, I don't know, it's a tie. It's really, really a tie between Quavo and Takeoff. And it's just sad because I did not expect Takeoff's album to be like that. So I'm just gonna say it. I'm just gonna be loyal. I'm gonna be loyal to the end. And the person who I think who had the best album is, of course, Quavo. Yes, Quavo. Let's just say Quavo. But it's really, really, really a tie between Quavo and Takeoff's album. But I'm gonna be loyal. I'm just gonna say Quavo because he did have some songs that I like better than Takeoff's. Like he had the How About That? I love that song. I like Honcho Dreams and I like Rerun. So that's it. Quavo won. I think Quavo should be a solo artist. Anyways, he seems like he's a solo artist. Even when I was at their concert, he was the only one interacting with the crowd, doing the ad-libs. It seems like more people like to do music with Quavo opposed to Takeoff and Offset. But overall, Quavo Quavo won with the best album out of Migos. Now, in below the comments, tell me what you think regarding this video. Who has the best album between all three? That concludes everything. I just want to say thank you guys for tuning into my channel. Make sure you guys subscribe, follow me on IG, Sierra_Spongia, and be safe. Love you guys.